Normalization isn't always about dividing by area. Hi, I'm Heather and I'm a cartographer. Before you watch this video, go back and watch my earlier one, Why Do You Need to Normalize Choropleth Maps? This video expands on that one. I'm going to explain normalization a bit more fully. I'll use ArcGIS online, but the concepts are relevant to any mapping situation. Normalization is an adjustment that you do to your data to make comparisons more meaningful. Here's a non-map example. If the average cost of a TV was $300 in 1960 and is $900 now, does that mean that TVs are more or less expensive now? It's hard to say until I adjust the values for inflation. Adjusting monetary values for inflation is a kind of normalization. It allows for more meaningful comparisons. Let's look at a map example. This map shows the number of unemployed people in each county in the United States. It seems to show that there's a lot of unemployment in California and near large cities. But of course, there are more unemployed people in places that have more people in general. This map mostly just shows us where people live. So my suspicions are triggered. Does this map allow for meaningful comparisons? Let's take a closer look. Hudspeth County, Texas has 79 unemployed people. But let's pretend for a minute that every single person in this county was unemployed. It would still have fewer unemployed people than neighboring El Paso County just because El Paso County has more people. Hudspeth County would still have a fairly pale blue color, even though it had a very dramatic unemployment situation. Now I know that this map does not allow for meaningful comparisons. I need to normalize this map for two reasons. First, I've noticed that comparisons across features are not meaningful. Second, I remembered the rule that choropleth maps should not use raw values like counts or totals. They should use derived values like percentages, averages, rates, or ratios. Watch my other video, Choropleth Maps versus Graduated Symbols, to learn more about this distinction. If I normalize the data for this map, that will turn the raw values, number of unemployed people, into derived values. And if I do it right, it will create a map where comparisons across features are meaningful. The question is, how should I normalize the data? I could divide the number of unemployed people by land area. That's what I did in the last video, and it's a very common way to normalize a choropleth map. But I have to check my work to make sure it makes sense. My goal in normalization is to allow for more meaningful comparisons, and this map, it's still just showing me where most people live. So even though technically I have normalized my data and I'm using a derived value, I still haven't made a very useful map. So instead, I'll try dividing by the total population. Much better. Now I can see where unemployment is high, independent of population. And indeed, dividing by the total is also a very common way to normalize choropleth maps. But when I stopped to think a little further about unemployment, I realized that not everyone in that total population is eligible to work. Maybe a better value to divide by would be the total labor force. If I do that, I finally get the map I want, a map of the unemployment rate, where comparisons across counties are meaningful. So if you're making a choropleth map, how do you know if you need to normalize your data? If your data are raw values, counts or totals, then yes, you need to normalize them. If you have derived values, like a percentage, average, rate, or ratio, then you don't, although you should still consider if there is a more appropriate derived value for your particular map. You still have to ask if your map allows for meaningful comparisons. Here's a map of median household income. Do I need to normalize it? No, because the median is already a derived value. And the median is considered a good way to compare incomes. Comparisons in this map are meaningful. There's more money being made in the green counties than the blue ones. Here's a map of housing units built in the 90s. Do I need to normalize it? Well, number of housing units is a raw value, not a derived one, so yes, I need to normalize. And if I zoom in again, look at El Paso and Hudspeth counties, I wonder, are there more houses built in the 90s in El Paso simply because there's more houses there in general? Probably. Choosing a couple of sample features like this to analyze is a good way to test if your map allows for meaningful comparisons, and this one doesn't. I'll normalize the data. I'll divide it by the total housing units. Now, El Paso and Hudspeth counties have almost the same color, and we can see where houses built in the 90s are more or less common. Once you know that you need to normalize your data, how should you do it? Dividing the value by area or by total are the most common ways, so try those first. But also ask yourself, what is the purpose of your map? What questions do you want to ask of your data? Does this map allow for meaningful comparisons?